Hey everyone, and welcome back to Nioh. On this video, we're going to be doing the main mission Deep in the Shadows, which is a level 12 mission with a difficulty of 2. But before we do that, I want to spend some skill points and level up. So let's go to my skills. As you can see, I've got 7 samurai skill points unused. And I'm going to get 2 abilities. The first one is Iai Quick Draw, which costs 3 points. It gathers power while keeping your sword in its scabbard for a quick draw and rapid strike. Can only be used when your sword is sheathed. So you do that by holding R1 plus circle, and it does this attack right there. And it's a very powerful attack. We saw one of the revenants use it, and it's actually quite effective against revenants. So I want to pick that up. And the other one I want to get is this one right here, Living Water Man. Mild stance only enables you to use key pulses even when dodging. This is so important. I highly recommend any stances that you use, get the Living Water ability for it. It just makes the game so much better because you can dodge and key pulse at the same time. It just makes moving in and out of combat or just moving around an enemy so much better. Highly recommend it. So pick that up for sure. And now I have Living Water for low stance and mid stance, which are the 2 stances I pretty much exclusively use. I hardly ever go into high stance at all. I just don't really like it. And I'm a little worried the points I spent in it were wasted, but it's only 3 points, so it should be fine. Now, we've got 4 ninja skill points I haven't used, and it's going to stay that way for a little while. I still want to do some experimenting, see which abilities I want for it. And we've got 2 Anmyo magic skill points, which I'm going to use right now. I'm going to get the Pure Mind 1. It's a passive ability, and it raises your Yokai realm by 100, which I'm pretty sure is the negative effects of being in a defilement field. So that seems very useful to me, so we're going to pick that up. All right, and now we just need to level up. So let's go to the starting point and the shrine and level up. And I've been experimenting with different stat allocations, and it seems that the best strategy with your stat points is to get everything up to about 10 to 15 points. It varies depending on the skill because they each have their own sort of soft caps where diminishing returns start to get pretty brutal. So I can show you exactly what I'm talking about with body. If you see, I put 1 point in, I get 30 life. 4 attack on the spear and 3 attack on the gun. If I put in another point, I get 30 life again, but this time only 2 attack on the spear and 2 on the gun. And another point would put that life in half to 15 and only 1 attack on the spear and gun. So you can see it's quickly getting diminishing returns. So it's best to sort of spread out your points through all the different stats, in my opinion, and get the most bang for your buck. And then once you're happy with sort of your baseline of stats being at a 10 to 15 level, then you can just pour points into whatever stats you like the most. And in my case, it's probably going to be heart because that'll raise my sword damage. But anyways, body's going to go up to 10 for now. And I think I'm going to put 1 point into stamina, which gives me 25 life, 0.9 to my equipment weight max and negative 1.6% to the equipment weight rate. And it'll also give me a samurai skill point, but I'm pretty sure that's just for leveling up. So any point anywhere would have gave me that point. And that's all the leveling I can do. So let's go ahead and accept that. And that gets me up to level 19. All right, we are ready for this mission. Welcome, Hanzo. It is good of you and your friend to come. Sir William, was it? I am told that you have a certain measure of skill in dealing with yokai and monsters. It is with these abilities in mind that I have a favor to ask. My son, Nagamasa, has gone off to defeat a band of rogues, and I have not heard from him since. I would go to his aid myself, but my body is not what it once was. Will you go and save my son in my stead?
Of course.
In the north of Kyushu, beneath the mountains of Nakatsu, lies a complex warren of limestone caves created by eons of erosion. Bold rogues make their home in the shallowest levels, but even they fear to tread into its deepest depths.
Hmm. cat clock. Anzo's ways are curious indeed.
I know of the guardian spirit called Nagamasa.
Even cats speak in these lands.
Allow me to possess you. We are Nigitama, guardian spirits, born from the light of human faith and belief. The Aratama, fiends, are born from the darkness of human grudge and anger. The world of the living perches atop this delicate balance between light and dark. Long years of strife have fueled the fiend's power, and now yokai prowl the earth. Now you should thank me for allowing you to converse in the tongue of this land. May 1600, Nakatsu, Buzin Province. I sense the presence of a strong one. If you follow it, it may lead to Nagamasa. Alright, let's do it. And we got an enemy up ahead, let's switch. Oh! Well, he's mad. We're gonna fight that enemy. I just danced around him, took him out. Alright, we got this guy. And he's dead. Got some rifle ammunition, arrow, and some gold. And let's just break some stuff in here. See if we get any extra items. Got some rifle ammunition. There's some gold over here. And over here, we got some stuff. And a box right here, a crate. Yokai water pot and arrows. And I meant chest, not a crate. Alright, so you can fall off these cliff edges, so be very careful. There's an enemy up on the left that's gonna try to knock you off. We're not gonna let him do that. Oh, almost dashed right off. Well, that would have been bad. Okay, I'll switch back to mid stance. You can see that corpse just fell down to that ledge. We can't get it at the moment, but keep that in mind. And if you notice, there's some bats to the left. So if I was to move forward like one more step, they're gonna come out. And if I don't block and they hit me, they'll push me. Now there's a fence here which will block me from falling, but in lots of cases, there's no fence. So bats will kill you in this level by knocking you off a cliff. But I should be able to just trigger them and not have them hit me at all. Okay, let's use our bow on this guy right here. Let's see if we can get his friend as well. Oh, perfect. Oh, come on, there we go. That's it, do the execution. Perfect. And I got an elixir, but I think that went to the storehouse. Got that gold there. Let's go ahead and shoot this guy. Oh, didn't lead it enough. Oh, dang it. Well, use three arrows for him. That's unfortunate. There's another enemy over here. There he is. Cut to shreds. And we got our first revenant, Fudoshin, level 12, shot down by an outlaw. Oh, camera went crazy. It's a dual wielder. Oh, he got me. Yay, quick draw! Boom, as you can see, quite effective against these guys. They are kind of bad about avoiding it. I guess they don't see it coming. But it usually won't work twice in a row, so they're usually smart enough to not get hit by it twice, but we'll see. Maybe this guy's dumb. Although I might just, yeah, we'll just finish him off like that. Okay, I got some armor and an Ochoco, and let's go up this path. Well, let's break this stuff first. Let's go up that path and get that loot that guy dropped. Hey, I got my 3 arrows back. Let's go over here, break some stuff. Oh, that's a chest. Got a little chest over here we can open. Spirit Iron Fragments times 3 and a Heroku Dama, or 2 Heroku Damas. We got an enemy sleeping. I think we can sneak up on him. Yep, that was perfect. And he's gone. Alright, we got our first Kodama. Let's send him to the shrine. There's 8 of them in this level. So 7 more to go, and here's another chest. Got a Hyotoko mask. And a small spirit stone. What is a Hyotoko mask? A mask that harbors the power of the god of the stove. When used, it spews flames from its mouth into the area around you. Interesting. Have to use that at some point. Let's break these, and let's go down this way. Now, beyond this door are 2 enemies waiting to kill you. Just be aware of that. Finish that guy off. That'll make this easy. Oh, didn't block that. Man, this guy's in trouble. Boom. And let's just go ahead and use this elixir so I can pick that one up and get a weapon there. Thing in this? No. What about this one? No. You built a wall. Now you're staring at me. You keep it up and I'll poke them eyes out. Have you noticed how the walls have eyes? They seem to be interested in you. Whole bunch of stuff in there, nice. So what he's talking about are those eyes right there. Now this is actually an enemy, he's pretty mean, so I suggest using your living weapon for him. We're gonna hit the wall, and he's angry. Use the spirit weapon, and go crazy. Picked up a title, Roughneck, and I also hit maximum familiarity with my sword. Let me get out of there. And he's dead. Picked up the title, Nutakabe Cutter. Got a stone, spirit iron chunk, 2 spirit iron fragments, and a weapon. And we got a revenant here. This is Suzu, level 12. Crushed to death by Nutakabe for his hostile behavior. And we got a dual wielder. Oh, ow. Oh, he's low on... He got invulnerable and dead. And we picked up the title Revenant Slayer. Alright, we got a chest here. 4 arrows, longbow, which is apparently better. And oh, I'm actually full up on arrows. Let's check out this longbow, and it is indeed better. But not the best. Not the best special effects, but still, so much more damage. We're gonna take it. And let's go ahead and shoot this guy down here. Not quite dead. 1 more might do it. There we go. And pick up that arrow. And let's go this way. Oh, we got an enemy. Oh, block that. Oh, I thought he was dead. I don't know why I thought that. Now he's dead. We got a big old armored dude. It looked like he was going for a quick draw, didn't it? I wonder if he can do a quick draw. Anyways, he's dead, and there's another elixir. I think I'm just going to use this one and pick that up. Jumanji Spear, got the boss's room key. Your Chico Powder, some armor, some gold over here. Let's loot this corpse. Damn it. How many do I have to kidnap? We got a sacred water butt. We're capped out on those. I need to start using those. Because apparently I can only hold 6 at a time. Got spirit iron fragments times 4 and a summoner's candle. And we got a revenant over here. This one's dead heat Matsuburo, level 12, cut down by a rogue. Well, let's go ahead and use the sacred water. And we'll fight it. And it's a sword wielder. Looks like he might be in mid stance. Oh, ow. Ow. Get away from me. Ow. Well, he's kicking my butt. I don't like that. There we go. Yashi quick draw. Boom. Oh, man. Oh, he's out of key. He's in trouble. And he's done. And I got a Bison Osafuna. Oh, it's a sword. I got a purple sword. I'm not getting rid of that. And now we can pick up that sacred water. All right, so I got that boss's room key, which is a room up at the top of this cave. Let's head on up there. Use it right here. And we got an enemy sleeping. Let's see if we can sneak up on him. Nope, not quite. But I did land the first hits. Oh, got me with his axe. Well, we definitely need to heal. Oh, ow. That was really close. Final blow. Not quite dead. Still not quite dead. There he goes. Let's see, got a accessory, sword, quality leather cord, a memory charm, a spear, and another charm, and arrows, but I'm maxed out. And we got our second Kodama. Okay, let's open up this chest. We got a Horagai shell, and some armor, and salt. So what is a Horagai shell? It's a horn made from a conch shell, blown to produce a deep trumpet-like sound, often carried by mountain ascetics called Yamabushi. They are also blown on battlefields to signal or rally troops. So I used this before and it seems to just cause enemies to come to you. So I don't really know why that would be overly useful, but if for whatever reason you want enemies to come to your current location, you can blow that horn and they should come running. Alright, we're coming up to an opening here. Let's see if we can shoot this guy. Yes, we can. Oh, and we made his friend angry. Oh! Well, he's in trouble. Stab him. Oh, you jerk. Received the title Swordsman Adept. Wow, this guy does not know how to manage his ki, so he's gonna die. And we got an elixir, 3 Kyakudamas, and some armor. There should be an archer off to the right. We're gonna shoot him. There we go. And let's move this. That's going to make a platform above us, which we need to get to that corpse over there, which is the corpse that fell down from the raven earlier. And we picked up a longbow from that guy. Arrow. And there's a corpse here. Once I've taken those idiot villagers for all they're worth, the only one left is the boss. I picked up 2 earth amulets. Well, let's go back up to the top. And we can drop down to pick up that corpse. So I want to go over here. And you can see there's a platform there that I made. So drop down to that and then drop down to the corpse. Damn the samurai. But on the other hand, I picked up a whetstone and a bandit axe. I didn't expect to find a hot spring here. Why don't you try it? It'll cure even sword wounds. Alright, so this hot spring will get me back to max HP. And if you've never used one before, it'll give you a trophy. Right, we got an archer over there. Doesn't see me. Boom! That arrow actually went through the wall, but still worked. Let's sneak attack this guy. Oh, bad day for him. And let's send that elixir to the storehouse and loot this corpse for an antidote. Let's see, we got Hamaya arrow and some sort of weapon. And over here we got our third Kodama. Got a corpse here. We'll meet the same damn fate if we stay like this. And we got a signpost talisman. Revenant here, Kyutaro the pig. Cut down by an outlaw, level 12. It's a spear user. These guys, I don't like fighting at all. But so far, so good. Managing to hit him right before he hits me every time. I'm timing that well. Let's try a quick draw. Oh, he got out. Oh, but he's low on ki. And he's done. And I got some armor for that. Let's see. Drunken Goro Dayu. Fell to death. Level 11. So that's actually a hint here. If you turn the corner, you can see there's some bats, and if you don't block or evade these bats, you're going to your death. Let's just sneak up and back up, and we're good. Okay, now let's summon the Revenant. And I don't want to fight him here. Let's just drag him in here. And, oh great, it's a low-stance swordsman. Let's try a quick draw on him. Nope, he didn't get close enough. Oh, I tried to parry him, it didn't work. Oh, he's out of ki, and he's done for. Good night. Got some armor. This looks like a bat cave. Normally they're afraid of people, but things are different now. Alright, we got a shrine. So let's go ahead and check out these Kodama blessings, because we found a lot more Kodama, so we got more options. So we can get 20% increased amount of Amrita, still 1% weapon drop rate. We can get 2% armor drop rate, 10% elixir drop rate, or increased drop rate of materials by 15%. I think we're gonna go with the materials. So there we go. And I should have enough to level up. Yes, looks like I can level up once. So let's put it into strength. That's going to give me 10 health. 1 attack on the sword, 2 on the spear, 5 to key pulse, and 3 samurai skill points. So that sounds pretty good to me, and that'll get me level 20. So proceed, yes. Alright, and I'm done with the shrine. And we got a yokai. And we got another one. Three Kyakudamas, but I can't pick those up. Got another yokai, switch to low stance, and just slice away. And I got an arrow for that. Who the hell are you? That kimono. Are you... Okay, if you see there, we got some bats. So I'll just sneak up, blocking. And there they go. I got two salts, although I can only pick up one. And a Hyotoko mask. So I've got two of those now and two fire amulets. Alright, up ahead is a Kodama. He's hiding in these mushrooms. Just break those up, and there he is. That is number four. Okay, and we got a dude right here. He'll form together once I get close, and I'll just shoot him. There we go. And he got a little bit of armor and some gold. And up ahead, we got a Yoki. Now, I'm not going to waste my spirit weapon on him. I'm just going to fight him normal. But with my new abilities, with the dodging and keep pulsing at the same time, it shouldn't be too big of a problem. So get in there. I'm standing in the defilement. That's fine. Keep pulse out the cleanse. I can do a final blow on him. Can do another one. And he's gotten himself low again. Oh, but he's in the defilement, so he was okay. Oh, ow. Was not ready for that. Dodge out. Almost got hit. So, much easier, but still not a walk in the park, that's for sure. And he is dead. Alright, got spirit iron fragments, an elixir, and some other stuff. Alright, next up we got another one of these walls. Now I want to use my spirit weapon for this guy. So there we go, bust it out. And just swing away until it's almost out. And alright, dodge out. Let's see, he's throwing a rock. Get in there. Dodge out. And I should be able to finish him. There he goes. Let's see, got a spear, spirit iron chunk, high quality leather cozying, and an elixir, which is going to the storehouse. Got a corpse here. Weapon, and ooh, young samurai's lock. So that'll give me two samurai skill points. And I'm up to 8. Wow. I'll have to spend those at some point. I don't know what I want yet. So they're just gonna stay unused for a bit. Got a whetstone and a lightning amulet. And we got another revenant. Let's go ahead and use a sacred water. And let's fight him. It's level 17, Saizo the Entertainer. Cut down by Yoki. Oh, and he's using a Kusatagama. I'm not accustomed to fighting someone who's using one of those. But so far, so good. Let's try an Iai quick draw, but too far away. Oh, he threw a bomb at me. And I appear to be poisoned. Oh, he threw another bomb. Let's try the quick draw. Oh, it should work. Yeah. All right. Let's go down here. Or actually, no, let's go to the top. Because there's an alternate path you can take, and there's a Kodama on that path. So if you come over here where those bats were, we can drop down onto an enemy, which I almost killed. Let's finish him off. Got a quality ingot, so you can see that blessing seems to be working really well. Ever since I put that on, I've been getting lots of materials. We got another enemy here. Block! Block again. And missed that attack, but that one lands. And he's dead. Got some gold. The Kodama's right here. So that is number 5. We got this corpse right here. Where is Lord Nagamasa? I haven't seen him since he went to that glowing mushroom. So I'm gonna shoot this guy and then jump down and finish him off real quick, because he's got a friend who I don't want to be dealing with. Oh, but I missed my attacks because I didn't lock on. But now he's dead. Block that. Getting low on ki, but I should be able to finish him. There we go. Let's see, anti-paralytic needle and a small spirit stone. Anti-paralytic needle, an acupuncture needle that neutralizes paralysis and the accumulated effects of paralytic agents. When applied to the correct pressure points on the body, these needles can be used to treat a variety of ailments. And I believe the boss uses paralysis, so if I get myself paralyzed, I can use that to get out of it. Hopefully. We shall see. There should be an enemy on the left here. It's a Kodama. Oh no! Well, for the first time, I'm going to be using an antidote, and I can't find it. Crap. I thought I had that on my hotbar. Well, I guess I'm just going to eat this poison damage. Oh no, he did it again. What am I doing? This is terrible. Alright, I need to use... where is it? Antidote. There we go. Wow, I didn't prevent that much damage. That was really bad, but... that's okay. Got my elixir. Take me back to nearly full health. And let's go ahead and put that on my hotbar. Just in case I screw up again. There we go. And got some quality lacquer and some gold. The evil energy seems stronger up ahead. I just hope Nagamasa is okay. Now, there should be an enemy patrolling, and there he is. I don't want to push him off. Let me just back up and finish him. There we go. Got a spear. Let's loot this corpse. 4 Hamaya arrows. And you can see there's a dude patrolling there. He's actually kind of mean. And there's not much area to maneuver. So I'm going to use my spirit weapon on him. But I want to wait till he moves a little bit. Because there's another enemy right as you get to the bottom of the ladder. So I want to take him out quickly. And then I'll deal with the big skeleton. Or whatever he is. So let's just take this dude out quick. There we go. And now I'm ready for the big guy, which is gonna get the spirit weapon. I think he might have hit me before I got it out, but I'm not sure. No. Just imagining it. So he's down. If we come over here, there's a Kodama, which is, I've lost count. Number 5, I think? Or is he 6? No, he's 6. So just 2 more. And we got a Revenant, not the best place to fight one. Let's go ahead and use an enchantment to make it a little bit faster. And this is level 17, Sasuke the Ladder Performer, fell to death. And it's a spear user, of course. He ran himself out of ki, but I'm out of ki. Oh, there we go. This should finish him. Good. And got some warlord armor. And my enchantment on that sword is running out. Okay, let's climb back up to the top. And we got a Yoki right there. Now be careful. There's some bats on the right and they will try to kill you. Let's sneak up, blocking, and there they go. So they'll send you off that ledge and kill you. And we can sneak attack this guy. Like so. Good hit there. Oh, and he's in danger. Final blow. And dead. Search this corpse, and that gets us. Even if they escaped, they're already drained. But that's better than the alternative. And we got some armor and a sacred brush. And we got a corpse here. A small spirit stone. And there's a yokai over there. We're just gonna slice him up. And I got me an iron kozene. And we got a shinobi box and some young ninja's locks. So let's see what a shinobi box is. It's contains a surprising number of various ninja tools, given the container's compact size. Use it to restore 30% of the maximum number of ninjutsu items you can prepare. So that could come in handy when I get more into this ninja stuff. And the ninja locks will give me one more skill point. Okay. And let's actually go up. Not ready to go into the big room just yet. Up ahead, there's a spot I can drop down to a ledge. And it's kind of hard to land on. Let's see if I can get the right angle. See it right there? So you just want to barely fall off, and there we go. And, ooh, Squire's Jumanji Spear, purple and better. And I also got the title One-of-a-Kind Seeker. So let's see. My current spear... Oh, wait, that's my sword. My current spear is 106 attack. This one is... Ooh, 115, plus it's purple, so it's got all those special effects. Oh, definitely better. We're putting that on. And let's see. This drop is going to do some damage to me. There's no way to prevent it, so... just going to have to take it. There we go, 333 damage. And let's go ahead and head back up again. And I should probably heal that damage. Let's go ahead and do that. So this time there's another spot I can drop down to. And it's right here. And you can see we got a Yoki up ahead. And it's a bit problematic because there's not a whole lot of room to move. So I could either use my spirit weapon, which is tempting, or I could just use an enchantment and go with that. Let's see, how many lesser spirit things do I have? And why is it not on my shortcuts? Let's see, lesser spirit stones, we have 4 of them. Well, let's go ahead and use one of them. And that might get me to full Emrita. Yes, it does. I'm just gonna use the spirit weapon on him. I don't really want to risk falling here. So, seems like a smart idea. We'll just go crazy on him. Dodge out. And he died to the fire. And I got spirit iron fragments, weapon, another weapon, and some gold. You can see there's a shrine there, which I'll use in a second. Did I forget anything? Doesn't look like it. Okay. Let's go ahead and use this shrine. And, oh, I can level up again. Actually, it looks like I can level up twice. Well, let's go ahead and do that. Let's see, skill. Mainly affects what? Oh, all kinds of stuff. We get 10 life, attack on a bunch of weapons, keyhole, samurai skill point, all sorts of stuff. Yeah, let's just go ahead and do that. What about dexterity? That's for ninjutsu. We'll wait on that. How about spirit? Oh, a whole bunch of crap. And yokai realm. Okay, let's put one in spirit. That sounds good. And maybe another in stamina? Oh, I can't. I can only do two. Alright, well, skill and spirit, they can go up to 7. That sounds good. And alright, this will make us level 22. Alright, and I'm done with the shrine, and I got more elixirs, although most of those went to the storehouse. Alright, we can kick down a ladder here. And there's actually an enemy right there, you can just barely see him. I'm gonna drop down and do my attack on him. So that right there, and that one shot him. Got me a stone, and it looks like I got a Harakudama. But only one I can't carry anymore. Let's go ahead and descend. And there's quite a few enemies down here. So we want to be a little careful. We got those big guys to deal with. But before we deal with him, we got this guy over here. Let's get him to spawn. Oh! Aggressive. But didn't work out for him. He's dead. Alright, so I'm gonna have to deal with this big old guy. He's not too bad. It's just one of those enemies that if you make a mistake, he will do insane damage to you. So as long as you can prevent him from hitting you, which is, like I said, not that bad. It's pretty easy. Oh! Of course I get hit right out the gate. Throw a bomb at him, why not? Now he's made me all nervous because he hit me with a first attack. I don't like that. But we'll do that to him, dodge out, do some more hits. Oh! Well, I'm being bad. Let's use an elixir. Oh, and we got another enemy, I just heard it. That's no good. One of these little spear dudes. Dodge out. Well, this made this vastly harder, but we should be alright. Oh no! Oh well, this is crappy. We need to get myself out of this situation. We're gonna do that with the spirit weapon. So, use the lesser one. Use another lesser, and that should do it, I think. Yes. Okay. So, let's just use it right here. Get rid of this little guy. And dodge out. Good. That worked out quite well. We still got this one, though. Oh, my spirit weapon was still going. I didn't even know that. Okay. Then we just got this guy. Oh, no. Keep getting hit. No good. He's weak. Let's dodge out. Purify that, dodge his rock, and one more hit should do it, and he's left himself vulnerable, so there he goes. Alright, well that was interesting. Got an elixir, so we're back up to 8. We got a corpse here, which has a moment talisman, and two himarogi branches. And we got a revenant here, Suzo the Carver, level 18, beaten to death by One-Eyed Oni. Which was about the same fate I had. It's a low stance sword wielder. Oh, he just got tore up. Let's try Niyashi quick draw, but he never came close. Ah, traded blows with him there. Try the quick draw. Oh, he's done. He is done. Walked right into it. And got no choker for that. Let's use an elixir. Let's see. Daijin Sake. What is that? Sacred rice wine that bestows the god Daijin's protection, curing and temporarily preventing elemental-based damage. Daijin is an Onmyo god that occupies one of the eight divine directions. Alright, well, I don't know anything doing elemental damage on this level, so I guess we'll just hold on to that. It looks like we cleared out this spot at least. Not seeing any enemies, although some of them kind of come out of the ground. We got a yokai there. Just slice him up. Got a corpse here. Travel amulet. And we got a Yoki. One of the axe wielding variety. Give him some slicing. Dodge out. Look out. And he's vulnerable. Dead. Okay. Let's go over here now. There is some sort of like special enemy, and I let him get away last time, which sucked. But I think he's gonna give you something cool if you manage to kill him, and he's gonna try to run away from you, which he successfully did for me. So this time he's not getting away. Let's see, he should be through here. There he is. Throw a bomb at him. That didn't work. Well, I just wanna... Nope. Nope, get him. Don't let him get away. Ow, ow. You ain't going anywhere. Nope, nope, nope. Get over here. Nope, nope. Nope. Ha ha ha. Received the title Kappa Cutter. So he apparently just drops a bunch of stuff. He was trying. He almost got away. Not sure the best way to handle those guys. Obviously, bomb didn't work. Okay. Well, we got a revenant there. Let's deal with that after we check this tunnel he was in. We got a revenant back here, and there's also a Kodama back here somewhere. Ah, there he is. Oh, I just scared him. Come out, little buddy. It's okay. All right, he's going to the shrine. That's number 7, so just one more. And we got a revenant here, level 18. Ninjas hate pirates. He got froze to death. Guess that would be frozen. He's got an axe. They're usually pretty easy. They run themselves out of key just like that. So, pretty simple enemies. He'll probably just do that again. Yeah. They really are the dumbest revenants. And really reinforce my idea that high stance is terrible. But I did get a purple bandit axe. I could break that down for materials, or I could just keep it for use later if I ever decide to use an axe, but I'll probably just break it down. Alright, let's go ahead and do this revenant now. Level 15, Nosedive Yotaro. Froze to death. What's he using? Spear. Great. Spear again. I hate spear. Nope. Get sliced. Yeah, you quick draw and boom, but it didn't hit. Well, it did hit, but he blocked it. Try it again. That time, it landed clean. And he's pretty much done.
finish.
Got no choco and some armor. Alright, let's get this Yoki over there. Actually, let me get a little bit closer, because I think if I hit him with the surprise attack, he's going to go down and vulnerable. Which it looks like he did. So I can do that once, twice. And that was a good start with him. He's got the big old axe, so I gotta be careful. If he hits me with that thing, it's really bad. Dodge out. Get back in. He's got defilement. Cleanse that. And he's in trouble. Come on, buddy. And he is... Oh! Thought he was vulnerable. It looked like he was falling, but then suddenly, not so much. I'm really careful with these guys, because they're the type of enemy that, like, one mistake and you're dead. So. They, are a bit rough. Had to block there. Couldn't quite get out. And he's dead. And we got an elixir. I don't need it, so now I'll go to the storehouse. And, let's see. Let's take this path over here. There's some bats in it. So just block or evade. There they go. And just a corpse back here. I got away from that woman. But now what am I going to do? Three anti-paralytic needles, which, like I said, I believe will come in handy for the boss. And three Hamaya arrows, but I can't use them. I should probably use them now. Let's switch to them. Guess we could do this fight now. And I was gonna use my spirit weapon, which I think I still will, but I'll probably lead off with this Hamaya arrow. So let's hit him in the face. There we go, that's a start. Hit him as well. He's gonna throw a rock at me, that's okay. Let's get over to his friend. Spirit weapon. Slice away, hopefully finish him off. And we did. Okay, get out of there. Got this big old bruiser. Oh! Why do I keep getting hit by these guys? It's not even that hard. And I need to make sure I don't get myself backed up into a bad area. Let's use that elixir. I gotta stop getting hit by this dude. Oh! Left himself vulnerable and I dodged out. Bad. Could have just beat him up. I should have went in there too. Getting a little nervous with these guys. I don't like that they keep hitting me. And he's dead. Okay, I got an elixir, so I'm back up to 8. That makes me feel better. That's the path up. I'm all turned around now. Let's see. Go through here. Okay. Here's where I killed that dude. Gave me a weapon, and let's leave that elixir there for... Oh! He's throwing stuff at me. So, this guy. That's rude. Oh, he lived! Let's give him another one. And I received the title Dweller Cutter. And his stuff is up there. We'll go up there in a moment. Just some gear. This is a level 16 revenant, Shintaro the Immovable, death by explosion. So I guess the guy up top got him. And Kusadagama wielder. Oh, he's got some range on him. Okay, I gotta watch out for that. He must be in a different stance with it. Oh, jeez, this thing. It's kind of rough. Oh, look out. My key is really low. So is his. Okay, there we go. This should finish him. And he's done. And good thing I left that elixir out, because I can use this one and pick up that one. Okay, let's go this way. And just watch out. There is... A dude behind there. slice him up and picked up the title Stealthy One. Not sure why, that wasn't stealthy. And oh, Paralysis Amamori Charm. Spirit Stone and Spirit Iron Chunk. Times three. Let's see what that amulet is. Let's see, that one I like. This one was the one that was kinda eh. So let's see if this one's any better. It's got less defense, but it item drop rate 3.4%, that's really good. Change to defense spirit B minus, no idea what that means. Elemental attack damage up. I think I'm gonna use this one. So let's put that on. The other one's kinda whatever. Yeah, okay. And we got this stuff. I got a quality Tamahagane. Alright, and let me go pick up those Hamaya arrows I passed up before because I just used some. And I might just use another here. We're gonna spawn a Yoki. If I can get a quick hit on him, I'll do it. Oh, never mind. It's a one-eyed dude. Oh, but right in the eye, got him vulnerable. And out. Nice. Oh, get out. Okay, this is how it's supposed to go with these guys. I'm not supposed to get hit. They're slow. They're just strong. If they hit you, it's bad. But they shouldn't be hitting you if you're paying attention. I almost got hit there. A little overzealous on my attack. Almost did it again. Oh, jeez. Did it again. Wow. It's not the end of the world. Oh, my God. What am I doing? Now, let's just finish him with a bomb. Oh, got some scout armor, and it's light. Might want to put that on. Elixir. Good. That gets me back up. And Demon's Horns time one. All right, let's see what that item was. Let's see, it's this right here. Whoa, look at the defense difference. Level 14 versus 7. So way more defense, life, which is good. Key plus 4, damage from fall, which I don't care about. Yeah, this is way better. So this is going on. And it looks cool, too. Nice. Alright, let me go pick up that extra Hamaya arrow. And let's go this way. Loot this corpse. Shingeku Medicine. What is that? Secret medicine made by the legendarily talented Dr. Dosan Manase. Fully restores your health. Oh, so it's just a better, what are they called? Elixir. Okay, that could come in handy for this boss that we're about to do. And there's bats all through this tunnel, so just go slowly. Let them pass. Just block those. Should be some more bats. There they go. And where the heck is my last Kodama? Where did I miss him? So beautiful. Please take my blood. Hamaya arrows and summoner's candle. I thought... Ow! I thought the last Kodama was back here. Where is he? Uh-oh. Unless he's over there? No, uh-oh. Well, I gotta find that last Kodama, but let's finish up here first. Let's see, this is Wannabe Samurai, level 17, poisoned to death. Oh, bad camera. Oh, whoa. Okay, he's got a spear. Ow. Okay, I got him vulnerable, and should be able to finish him here. Nope, not quite. There we go. Oh, jeez, that was kind of scary. Okay, let's use that elixir. And we'll pick up that armor, and see, I'm all turned around. I could have swore the last... You know that Kadama might have been near that chest I picked up. Let's see here. Anti-paralytic needle. Nice. Alright, so the boss is right in there. But we need that last Kodama, so let's head back. And I thought he was in this area somewhere. I wonder if he's like hiding in this crap or up on that path. For whatever reason, I'm remembering the path. Let's see, he might be over here. Yep, there he is. Sneaky little guy. And there we go. All of this mission's Kodama spirits have been guided to the shrine. So we are ready for the boss. We got 7 elixirs. I would have liked 8, but that's fine. This boss is super fun, by the way. I love this boss. But we need to make sure we're ready for her. So let's make sure everything looks good. So let's go to equipment. We got our elixirs there. That's good. Antidote. We won't need that. Let's switch that out for the anti-paralytic... needles. We got our Hirokudamas and Kyakudamas. I doubt I'll be able to use those, but we'll see. We got a fire amulet. That could come in handy. Although I think I've got 2 of others. I don't want to have to switch this out. Oh yeah, I got 6 lightning amulets, so we should probably use those. Although I don't know if she's weak to lightning, but I also don't know if she's weak to fire, so let's just try lightning. Because I got so many of them. I kind of want to try that Hyotoko mask too, but I don't know if I'll have the opportunity. Because she moves around a lot. I don't think this is going to work, so let's not use that. Spirit Stone, good. Small Spirit Stone, I've only got 1, so let's just not use that. And honestly, the Living Weapon isn't that useful against her. So let's get something else instead. Well, we could use a Moment Talisman. Throw the Guardian Spirit at her one time. That might be good. Sacred Water. I think I'll use one of those. Spirit Stones. I suppose I could use. Lightning Amulet. Okay, I think we're good. So let's do this. Here we go. She's fast. Move out of those. Hit her when she's after she does something. And watch out. Don't let her get too close here. Oh, got me with the follow-up kick. All right, let me use an elixir. Watch out. Whenever she does that, you gotta dodge. So if she hits you with that, you get paralyzed. And here she. Oh, dang it. All right. Barely dodged that. Mid stance not working for me. I switched to low. Cure that. Oh. Okay, get out of that. Use the elixir. Ah. Ooh, got some good slices in. Oh, I haven't used my spirit weapon. Now, when you use this, I highly recommend you use that aspect of it, because if you get in close to her, she'll do this like life drain thing to you, and it's pretty nasty. She's vulnerable. Let me use a moment talisman. I should have went in there, but I didn't. Okay, let's out. Oh, threw some things at me. Let me switch to elixir. She's coming in. Slice her up. Oh yes. Oh, why am I in mid stance? Let's get back to medium. Oh. Or low, I meant. Oh! Alright, let's see. Oh, look out. Oh, that's that grab she tries to do. And that, like, drains you of a ton of health. Okay, get out of that. Oh, heal. All right, I got one more spirit stone. Ah. Okay, I need a heal. Ah, use the... Oh, no. Anti-paralytic. Oh, this is getting bad. Oh, no. Anti-paralytic. Okay, I need a heal. All right, this is getting bad. I need to... Nope, not do that. Oh, crap. Okay, we gotta focus here. Living weapon. Let's see, I can do a few slices on her, but then get out. Do that. Oh yeah, we're gonna get her. Got her. Oh, I love that fight. It's so much fun. I need more. Bring more men to me. Oh, I hope this game keeps having bosses like that, because that is so much fun. Let's see. We got plate mail medium purple. Got a new sword, but I like my purple one. Pick up the rest of this stuff. What is that? Ooh, that's a purple sword. Got all kinds of stuff. Holy crap. All right, we need to check this out. So I did get a purple sword. And it's up here. 95 attack, which mine? I got so many items, my god. Let's see, 95 versus 102, so it's less. Oh, let me look at the other stats of it. Grapple damage, up, high attack break, parry. High attack, I assume, means high stance, which doesn't help me. Paralysis plus 4, strong attack damage plus 10%, that doesn't help me. Strong attack key reduction. I think I like mine slightly better. Both of them aren't great, but the other one's better, I think. So we'll stick with that. What about this other, like, armor I got? I got heavy versus my light. I don't want to... Well... Ooh, it is good stuff, though. But mine is also good, so we're gonna stick with what I got. And let's see, we got these. Defense, life, running speed increase. What does those have? Life, toughness, evasion key usage, and dash key usage. That's really good. Way more defense on this, though. Ooh, that's a tough one. It's a very tough decision. I like the evasion key usage down and the dash key usage critical, although I'm not quite sure what that means. First this, well, let's go with this. It's so much higher level and it has way more defense. So let's go ahead and switch that out. And I think that's it. Yeah, that looks like it's it. Okay. Mission complete. Let's finish up. This will end the mission. Proceed? Yes. I thank thee, truly. I have always been confident in my spear work. But this marks the first time I faced a yokai. Years of war have ravaged my homeland, and now it is infested by yokai. Now the country is riven in two, and battle looms between the clans Ishida and Tokugawa. For the sake of this land and its people, we must make it our last. possessed by Fuse Ushi via Spirit Division.
So
drink, drink, drink the night away. Damn that Ishida and his schemes that pulled my father down. I will join Master Ieyasu and make him pay. Nagamasa, calm yourself, we have a guest.
I don't have time for this.
Calm down. Everything has been taken care of.
Lord Kanbei, I suspect you knew the yokai did it all along. A golden-haired samurai. Rarer a sight than a yokai. Inform Master Hanzo that strange things are afoot in Tachibana of Baizen.
Who are you?
I dislike the company of drunk samurai.
Hey! I am no samurai.
So a common drunk. Even worse.
Trophy earned! They call him Anjin. Mission complete. Deep in the shadows. Sir William, I can't thank you enough for saving Nagamasa. You have my utmost gratitude. That said, though my fellow countrymen and I have some familiarity with foreign names, I'm afraid I cannot help but find yours difficult to pronounce. Might I suggest calling yourself Anjin from now on? It means pilot in Japanese, fitting for a seafarer such as yourself. I'm sure those of this land will find that easier to understand. And we got our rewards and some other stuff, Amrita and whatever those gear things are. Twilight Mission in Ominous Cavern unlocked. Okay, so we finished the mission. Let's go ahead and go to our starting point to the blacksmith. And we'll just sacrifice all my stuff I picked up. Or not sacrifice, disassemble. And hand cannon. Oh, that was one of my rewards. I'm going to hang on to this for now. Because look how much damage it does. Because I'm not familiar with what exactly that is. And the rest of this stuff is going to go, though. I decided to not use this sword, so we're going to break it down. And all the rest of this stuff is getting broke, including that bandit axe. I decided not to keep it. And we're going to have so much material. Not sure if it's going to be worth it or not. But I've been told you can sell material for quite a bit of money. So either way, it shouldn't be a waste. And longbow's going, and so is that spear. Okay, now on to this stuff, and yep, just all of it's going. Unless it's purple, I don't really care. Even if this stuff is higher level, I can always make mine higher. And we'll get rid of that as well. So, yeah. This game loves loot. It gives you a whole lot of it. Which is, I don't know, kind of annoying sometimes, but mostly it's fine. Let's see, I decided to go with those, so, yeah, let's get rid of these. And just the feet. Alright, and then I believe I have to sell my... the, accessories that I pick up. So let's do that. Should give me some money. So that can go. As well as that, as well as that, as well as that. That, and let's go ahead and keep that for a little bit, just until I know for sure I don't want any of this stuff, because Amrita Sense could be good. Change to Defense Spirit could be good as well, so let's go ahead and keep this thing, just in case. And alright, so that's all taken care of. Let's leave the blacksmith, let's check out my Amrita thing and my titles. You can see my reputation points are 6 of 8. Don't know what that means, but I've gotten 8 titles with Agyo, 8 with Ungyo, and oh, I think it's shared. Okay, that makes more sense. And I guess as I get prestige, I get some bonuses, so I should be pretty close. I don't know. Okay, we'll figure that out later. And we got some new Amrita memories, so we got some new yokai. We got Skeleton Warrior, yokai taking the form of armored skeletons. Warriors who are unprepared for their death when it comes, or who take their own lives, return as these angry spirits to roam the battlefield and assault the living indiscriminately. We still have the Dwellers, we haven't killed 100 yet, so no new lore on that. We got Kappas. Kappa are diminutive yokai with green skin, a dish-like depression on their heads, and a turtle-like shell on their back. They generally lurk underwater, but they often emerge onto dry land as well. In the water, kappa are faster than fish, and they are known to commit evils like seizing children playing in rivers by the leg and dragging them under, or stealing the shiri kodama soul from people's behinds and leaving them listless shells of their former self. That sounds nice. Good thing I killed that jerk. And if we kill 3 of them, we get some more lore. We got the Yoki, we got the one-eyed Oni, a gigantic Oni with a single eye in the center of its face. Oni with 2 eyes were originally human, or at least born of human, ugly human passions in some way. One-eyed Oni, however, are said to be the wild, bestial side of mountain gods and local spirits personified. And man, are they ugly. And if we kill 20 of them, we get some more lore. We got the Nerakabe. The yokai known as Nerakabe take the form of a giant living wall. They are said to most enjoy simply standing where no wall should be, and enjoying the unease and confusion of travelers. If left alone, they will not move, but if harassed, they extend long arms to strike back in rage. Slow moving, but with immense strength and stamina, Nerakabe are formidable foes, which we indeed found out. And if we defeat 3, we get some more lore, and I believe we're at 2. We got the Onlyoki, which we didn't run into again. We got Hino Inma, pronounced Hio Inma, a yokai taking the form of a young woman, deceives humans and drinks their blood. The name Hino Inma literally means flying bad luck, and she is believed to cause all manner of troubles and misfortunes. She is believed to have been born from the angry soul of an innocent woman senselessly struck down in the heat of a battle. And apparently there's going to be more of these. So not just a boss, but an enemy at some point. A regular enemy. And there we go, we're done with that. We got Guardian Spirit illustrations. And we found this new one, Fuse Ushi. Fuse Ushi is a bull spirit that protects believers from misfortune. Bovines have long served alongside humans, providing their strength in agriculture and other ways to support our lives. For this reason, some civilizations actually ban the consumption of their meat and venerate them as a sign of thanks. Pat its stomach as a sign of respect, and the Fuse Ushi will absorb negative ki. The great Kuroda Nagamasa decorated his helm with a bull ornament in hopes of becoming a fierce warrior with a heart as gentle as the Fuse Ushi. Alright, and we got our character directory. What happened here? Ah, something new with Hatoi Hanzo. Hanzo keeps a cat inside his garments and uses it instead of a clock, checking the time by closely examining the dilation of the cat's pupils. In fact, the cat is possessed by a Nekomata, an exceptionally long-lived guardian spirit. But as Hanzo cannot see spirits, he does not realize this. And we got Okatsu. Katsu is a female ninja, or kunoichi, under Hatoi Hanzo. Trained in the same Iga ninjutsu as Hanzo, she accompanies William on his travels. Kunoichi are as skilled as warriors and spies as male ninja, but are also able to masquerade as powerless women to encourage targets to let their guard down, or disguise themselves as maids to gather information. Katsu's mastery of every aspect of the ninja way is said to rival even her teacher Hanzo's, and makes her a strongly trusted figure. And we also got Kuroda Nagamasa. Kuroda Nagamasa, sometimes known as Kichibe, was a general under the Toyotomi clan, the son of Kuroda Kanbai. Nagamasa was entrusted to Hideyoshi as a child hostage. When Kanbei was captured by enemy forces, however, Oda Nobunaga suspected him of treachery and ordered Nagamasa killed. It was only quick thinking on the part of Takenaka Hanbei that saved him. After coming of age, Nagamasa made his name fighting alongside his father for Hideyoshi at Shizugatake and during the conquest of Kyushu. As a leader on the front lines, his opinions often clashed with those of Ishida Mitsunari, who provided support from the rear. Since he also believes that his father's removal from the center of power was due to slander by Mitsunari, he bears a grudge against him. And we also got Kuroda Kanbai. Kuroda Kanbai is a general under the Toyotomi clan. His real name is Kiyoaki? And towards the end of his life, he adopted the name Yoshitaka. He is the father of Kuroda Nagamasa and served Hideyoshi as staff officer, providing battlefield assistance. After the Hanoji incident, when Hideyoshi found him in a tight spot, Kanbei successfully led a massive retreat known as the Chugoku Rollback. This and other accomplishments earned him a reputation as an unparalleled military strategist. Hideyoshi, however, was wary of Kanbei's brilliance, and gradually forced him away from the center of power and all the way to Kyushu. Kanbei was captured and imprisoned by enemy forces in his youth, and the damage done to his body then never fully healed. He walks with a stick and is physically in decline, but his ambition to be ruler of the whole nation remains as unclouded as ever, and he is watching current events with keen interest. Kanbei is sensitive to social and political change and knowledgeable about other countries. He showed no timidity in dealing with William in an age where foreigners were a rare sight in Japan. He even recommended that William adopt the name Anjin, pilot, since his real name would be so difficult for Japanese to pronounce. Kanbei continues to watch William closely, sensing in him the possibility of changing the course of Japanese history. And finally, we have Sinje Tome. Sinje Tome is the granddaughter of the current Sinje Munemasa, legendary swordsmith of Ise Province, present-day Mie Prefecture. She has been initiated into the Muramasa teachings and is a remarkably skilled blacksmith and appraiser. With Muramasa's whereabouts currently unknown, she is running the forge in his absence, continuing the tradition of fine Muramasa blades. It is said that if a Muramasa sword is thrust into a river, fallen leaves will spontaneously be drawn to it and sliced in two. This mysterious power may be what sparked the rumors that Muramasa are evil swords that can draw their victims to them. And it says to unlock, give one of Kagatsuchi's Magatama to the blacksmith. I have no idea what that is. Alright, and finally, some extra information on the story. We have Hotaru Hanzo the ninja. William slays the... Wait, we already did this. That's weird. Here we go, feline intervention. William sets out in search of Nagamasa at the request of Kuroda Kanbai. Just then, Nekomata, who is neither guardian spirit nor Oni, appears before William. Nekomata claims to know Nagamasa well and agrees to lead William to him. With his newfound ally beside him, William descends deep into the cave. Darkness descends. William continues his journey into the cave, feared by even the toughest bandits. Lying in its darkest depths is an Oni known as Hino Inma, which lures humans to its lair in order to trap them and feed off the blood from their still living bodies. And the rescue of Kuroda Nagamasa. William rescues Kuroda Nagamasa from the clutches of the Hino Inma. Nagamasa offers his thanks, and William obtains the guardian spirit known as Fuse Ushi. Although not the wisest of samurai, William takes a liking to Nagamasa and his easygoing nature. And a banquet is held in William's honor at the Kuroda clan's mansion. However, William leaves the party early, eager to resume his pursuit of Kelly. In the courtyard, he meets Hanzo's Kunoichi Okatsu, who brings word of trouble befalling the Tachibana clan. Alright, so we're all cut up on lore and story, and we've completed our mission, we broke down all our stuff, so we are ready to wrap it up. So thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.